Welcome everyone to King's Quest 3. I'm your host Lostwolfe, and this is episode 3. Now, I want to talk very quickly about the big overarching system in this game, and that's the spellbook. The spellbook is a book that you come across in Mananan's basement, and you use it. It's his grimoire. We're going to talk about specifically one spell. We're going to brew a lot of them in succession, but we're going to talk about one spell called Flying Like an Eagle or a Fly. And the way all these spells work is you turn to a page, you follow a specific method. In this case, it's put a pinch of saffron in essence. And once you've done that, you do a recitation. And this is true of every single spell you're ever going to brew. You do the recitation, which is a little poem, and then you wave the magic wand, which is the thing that we don't have and we're going to collect. So that is our plan for the episode today. For those of you incidentally who played AD&D, you'll recognize a lot of this because it takes the same idea. Use components, the components are bound together with a little vocal recitation, and off you go. On top of that, when you're done, you take your eagle feather or your fly feather, you'll dip it in the essence you've created, and then you'll use that to recite a little incantation, and that will allow you to fly as an eagle or a fly. I shall meet you in game, and that is exactly what we're going to do. Right, we're back in King's Quest 3. And we're going to go right ahead and we're going to brew up our eagle or fly spell very quickly. Now, to do that, we need to head right into the den of the beast, which is over here. This is Mananan's study. Mananan is very private with his study, and doesn't like you poking around. The huge oak desk is covered with his writing implements. An oak cabinet is in the corner. There is a chest and on the rear wall. Sorry, a chart on the rear wall. The bookshelves are filled with books on every subject. The wizard fancies himself to be quite a scholar. There's a little cabinet there. The oak cabinet has a brass handle on its door. Your leather duster is lying on top. You unlock the oaken cabinet using the brass key. Inside you find the wizard's magic wand. You take it with you, knowing it could mean death if he finds it missing. After closing the door, you carefully relock it. This is essentially true. Now, on the floor, we can see there's an anomaly here. It's something weird. We just need to find out how to get that open, because it looks a bit like a trapdoor. Look, books. Carefully examining the bookshelf, you notice a glint of metal behind one huge volume. Pull book. The book comes. You push the large book aside, revealing a metal lever attached to the back of the bookshelf. Let's pull the lever. Hey, a trapdoor. A trapdoor opens, revealing a steep stone steps leading into darkness. Now, it's possible for the cat to stealthily get in here and defeat your purpose and kill you, but fortunately he wasn't here. So we're gonna go right ahead and we're going to brew up our spell. Before we do that though, you curiously gaze at the strange jars of ingredients, the animal and human bones and other odd implements which line rows of shelves. You see jars of ingredients resting on labeled shelves, shelves bearing such ghastly names as powdered fishbone, nightshade juice, mandrake root powder, saffron, toad spittle, and toadstool powder. Now, of those, we do need all of them, but we're going to get a saffron, and we're going to work with that, and we'll come back and get the rest later. So, get the saffron, you remove the jar labeled saffron from the laboratory shelf, and carry it with you. Here's our cutter, you hold a small ball of, a small ball of black cat fur in your hand. Saffron. Inside the jar you see saffron, an orange-yellow powdery substance. I haven't shown you the boss key. The small boss key is brightly polished, and the wand, the magic wand, there we go. The magic wand is cool and smooth to the touch, and creamy white in color. You think it might be fashioned from ivory. And here's where we do our bringer spells. Okay, so here's how this works. We're going to turn to one of the pages in the book, and we're going to follow all the instructions. So, our first instruction is we need to be at page XXB, which is page 25. So off we go. With trembling hands, you turn the pages of the sorcery of old and prepare to follow instructions precisely. If you don't, bad things happen. Actually, we don't want to do that. Yeah, we don't want to do that. We don't know the ingredients for it. We're going to turn instead to page 4. You know you must work with the utmost care. Every step is critical. Each must be done in the proper way and the proper sequence. You tremble in anticipation. You carefully sprinkle the precious saffron into the vial of rose petal essence. You wave the magic wand over the vial of rose petal essence. Successfully completing the spell, you again look at the wizard's laboratory. And that gives you a whole 10 points. So the spells are pretty important. Right, having done that, we are going to save. And I shall meet you in the next episode, where what we will try and do is put our essence to good use. I'm Lostwolfe, you're watching King's Quest 3. I thank you for doing so, and I shall see you soon.